Good morning, and a very warm welcome to Sunday morning worship as part of Movilla Abbey Church. Wherever you are in this moment that you're watching, whether you're watching live or a little bit later on. Now, before I say a little bit more about today, next Sunday is Palm Sunday, the beginning of Holy Week. First thing to say to you is don't forget to put your clocks forward next Saturday night if you want to be joining us live at 11 next week. But with it being the beginning of Holy Week, not only are we planning a special online service next week, but we hope to have some special things online every evening through Holy Week so that together we can join in our Lord's journey to the cross from our homes. But until then, a reminder that you can continue to join us each evening at 7 p.m., either here on our YouTube channel or on our Facebook page, where we are journeying through the Psalms. We've been doing this all through Lent. It's not too late to join in. Each evening stands on its own, and you'll be very welcome to join us at 7 p.m. Each evening, we take 15 minutes, that's all, to light a candle, to read a psalm, and to pray for our world out of the words of that psalm. So we would love you to join us. Now, some good news. In 2 weeks' time, Easter Sunday, we are inviting you back here into the church building. Both the Church of Ireland and the Methodist Church announced this week that we are free to return. Isn't that wonderful news? So put the date in your diaries. We're inviting you to come back here for fellowship and worship at 11 a.m. All the safety precautions that you were used to before, if you were joining us for worship from September to December, will be back in place. So there will be limited seating, but we do have capacity both here and in the Nendrum Hall. So come early, and we would love to see you on that Sunday. Now, how are you feeling this morning? I was asking the team that puts on this service this morning to give either a thumbs up if they were feeling really great, a thumbs down maybe if not, or maybe halfway. I wonder where would you be on a scale of really good to really bad at the moment? And be honest with yourself about how you're feeling. Me, I'm about this morning, and that's being really honest. But you know, God welcomes us as we are. I'm going to read some words now from Romans chapter 12, where the Apostle Paul writes to the church there. Listen to these words. Here's what I want you to do, Paul writes, and I'm reading from the Message translation. Take your everyday, ordinary life, your sleeping, eating, going to work, and walking around life, and place it before God as an offering. Embracing what God does for you is the best thing you can do for him. Don't become so well adjusted to your culture that you fit into it without even thinking. Instead, fix your attention on God. You'll be changed from the inside out. Readily recognize what he wants from you and quickly respond to it. Unlike the culture around you, always dragging you down to its level of immaturity, God brings the best out of you, developing well-formed maturity in you. So let's take a moment to pray as we offer our everyday, ordinary life, wherever we are feeling this morning. Let's bring our everyday, ordinary life to God in prayer now. Heavenly Father, we offer ourselves to you in this moment, in this act of worship. Thank you that you don't expect us to come dressed in our Sunday best, pretending to be something that we're not. You see us as we are. So Lord, we give you all of our everyday, ordinary life, exactly as we're feeling. And we place it before you, Lord God, as an offering. And as we do that this morning, help us to embrace what you want to do for us. Because, Lord, you are a good God and you have good things to give us. And thank you that you can transform our lives from the inside out. Amen. Now, over the last 6 months, as a Movilla Church family, we've all been on a journey through the whole of Scripture together. Now, whether you were joining in with the readings faithfully every day, whether you have dipped in and out of that, and that's probably a lot of us, or whether Sundays has been your only contact with the E100 journey that we've been on, we have all journeyed together from Genesis to Revelation. And we've done that together because the Word of God is so fundamental to living well. When Jesus was at his very lowest ebb after 40 days of fasting prayer in the wilderness, his stored memories of Scripture was the first thing he turned to, and it gave him life and power to overcome the darkness. Throughout his ministry, he was guided by what Scripture said. And even in death on the cross, he reached for the words of Psalm 22. And if Jesus needed that, how much more do we? Human beings cannot live on bread alone. We need God's word for our souls to live. So let's join together now in reminding ourselves of the fundamental need of God's word for life by saying together some of Psalm 119. Oh, how I love your law. I meditate on it all day long. Your commands are always with me and make me wiser than my enemies. I have more insight than all my teachers, for I meditate on your statutes. I have more understanding than the elders, for I obey your precepts. I have kept my feet from every evil path, so that I might obey your word. I have not departed from your laws, for you yourself have taught me. How sweet are your words to my taste, sweeter than honey to my mouth. I gain understanding from your precepts, therefore I hate every wrong path. Your word is a lamp for my feet, a light on my path. I have taken an oath and confirmed it, that I will follow your righteous laws. I have suffered much. Preserve my life, Lord, according to your word. Accept, Lord, the willing praise of my mouth, and teach me your laws. Though I constantly take my life in my hands, I will not forget your law. The wicked have set a snare for me, but I have not strayed from your precepts. Your statutes are my heritage forever. They are the joy of my heart. My heart is set on keeping your decrees to the very end. Let's now give God the willing praise of our mouths as we sing together.
Oh,
Now, throughout the E100 journey over the last 6 months, not only have we had daily Bible readings, but we have had each Sunday a craft activity for our children to be involved with. They've had material that they can do with their parents. There's no craft activity this week. We're going to take a break this week, but I want to take this opportunity to thank our Sunday school, our children's leaders team, who have been working really hard over these last 6 months to put together activities and crafts for our children to be part of this journey as well. But it's not just been craft activities. If you've been joining in with the journey each day through our Facebook page, you'll have seen some amazing artwork done by an artist called Rich Wells. And now we're going to watch a short video that's going to remind us of the journey of the last 6 months that we've been on together as a congregation. We're going to hear some comments from some of you about how you found the journey, and we're going to be reminded of some of that beautiful artwork that we've all seen.
Wow, I made it. I finished on time and I really enjoyed the passages. Well, most of them at least. I really never expected to last the course. Just don't ask me if I was always up to date.
And it was a challenge that I looked forward to doing, and it was good to have a pattern made out for you to follow. And also it was encouraging to know that many other people were taking part in the same journey that I was. And in truth, for me, there were times when it wasn't always easy to keep up to date with the schedule, but I did need to remind myself that there wasn't going to be any punishment meted out because I hadn't ticked the boxes on time.
I found the challenge more interesting and much more of a blessing than I thought it would be. You know, reading back over those old stories that are fabulous in what they teach us, stories we learnt at Sunday school and maybe have shaped us all our lives. So I underlined lots of stuff, made a mess of the Bible, I'll have to say.
Well, folks, I've completed E100. It's been a great journey through the highlights of the Bible. But it's been more than that. It's been an encouragement to want to read the Bible more, to understand it better. And for that, it has been a wonderful resource, and I thank you for it.
I like the Bible challenge, or my normal Bible books, because we read it every night or some nights.
Often the readings in acts of worship are a few verses, but it was good to read a good chunk. Let us get into the rhythm of the writing to see the links between events and stories that we knew so well.
There was satisfaction on completing the course, and I want to keep on going with reading the Bible.
Yeah. There's no God like Jehovah. Behold, He comes. love that song by Rob and Mark, Days of Elijah, because it reminds us that the God we read about in Scripture is our God today. We are part of one continuous story. And that's what it means to be people whose lives are formed by the story of God. Our lives formed by a story. That might seem like a strange idea, but if you think about it, everyone's lives are formed by stories. Everyone lives out of different stories that we tell. So a football fan is part of the story of their team. Maybe they wear the strip, even though they don't play. And whether their team wins or loses can dictate how they feel day to day. They live in that story. Some people live out of a story that the best thing they can do with their lives is to make as much money as possible, climb the ladder, and die with as big a bank balance and as much prestige as possible. And whether or not they succeed at that goal that they've set themselves, that is their life. Because that is the story that they live out of. Too many people live out of a story that they are worthless, unlovable. Now, all of us live in these kinds of stories as well. We are not immune from living out of the different stories that there are around us. But for us, we choose to live and act out of a bigger story, a better story. The story that the one who made us loves us. That the one who made the world gives us purpose and authority in the world. The story that the pain and suffering and death that we experience is not how things are meant to be. That they are the result of selfishness and greed, ours and others. And that the one who made the world continues to be at work in the world, actually stepped in to the world so that we're not alone in our suffering, and more than that, rescued us from the consequences of our actions, forgives us, saves us, adopts us, changes us through overwhelming love. That's our story. That's the story that we choose to live out of, that it is love that animates the universe. And that there's a place for everyone. Like Alan said earlier, we've been on this journey together, hearing this story again from beginning to end. Whether you have dipped in and out, whether Sunday gathering has been your only contact with E100, I know that there's people who are taking part who aren't able to access the online Sunday gathering, but they have been following the readings every day. People have been taking part in Newtownards, in Dundonald, Belfast, West Fermanagh, Richhill, Wicklow, maybe further. People have been taking part as a solitary activity. People have been taking part as a family activity or alongside friends. People have been taking part with their life groups. We've journeyed from Genesis to Revelation. But everyone has their favorite parts of the story. So let's hear about some of those.
For me, reading through the E100 has been a journey through God's Word. And I have two favourite scriptures. The first one is Genesis chapter 1, verse 1. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Chapters 1 and 2 of Genesis just reminds me that God not only created me, but all of this amazing world that we live in, His creation. And then Revelations 1 verse 8. I am the Alpha and the Omega, says the Lord God, who is and who was and who is to come, the Almighty. God is the first and the last. He is the beginning and the end. And to me, that is just amazing.
My favourite scripture is 1 Thessalonians 4, verse 13 to 18. But we do not want you to be uninformed, brothers, about those who are asleep, that you may not grieve as others do, who have no hope. For since we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, through Jesus, God will bring those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a cry of command, with the voice of an archangel, and with the sound of a trumpet of God. And the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so we will always be with the Lord. Therefore, encourage one another with these words. This speaks to me because I've been very fortunate in having people that were very committed Christians in my life who have now passed on or who have fallen asleep in Christ. As the reading says. As a Christian, I just find it very helpful and very hopeful. So there will be joy in being with Christ and being in heaven, but there will also be that joy of being together with people that we've lost recently or longer ago.
Is that your favourite?
Yeah!
My favourite reading was Romans 8, and in particular verses 31 to 39. Life isn't easy, and it has its ups and downs, and our faith can have ups and downs as well. And there are times where we wonder whether God really does love us. That's where these verses 31 to 39 are so important to me, because they tell me that nothing can separate me from God's love. He's always going to love me. Sometimes we're not exactly likable, but we don't have to worry about His love. His love is there for us forever and through everything.
God is for us, and we will never be separated from His love. And no matter what happens, God will always be with us. It made me feel loved and reassured of the relationship that I have with God. And knowing that we are in God's eyes conquerors provides me with confidence. And it reminds me that we can do anything through Christ.
When I read these verses, I had intended to write them down. But I know myself, and my middle name should be procrastination, because there's always mañana. And if I know myself, God knows me even better. Alan sent me a message. Michael had asked me to do the reading this Sunday. I couldn't believe it. It was Romans chapter 8, verses 31 to 39. And not only that, he asked me to do it from the New International Version, which isn't the version of the Bible that I use. So I had to Google it, and I had to print it out. So I have these words, they're printed out, they're now stuck in the inside page of my Bible. So anytime I feel that I'm asking myself, does God really love me? They're there. They're there for me, and they're there for everyone. God loves us, because nothing can separate us from the love of God.
I enjoy seeing the recurrent themes in the Bible, themes that would run through the whole of Scripture, like a thread running through a tapestry. The theme of creation, the theme of water, the theme of human frailty and God's forgiving love, but most of all, of God's presence walking beside us day by day.
I love Google Earth, and I love that I can start with a map of my street, my house, my garden, and then I can zoom out to see all of Newton Ards, the whole peninsula, the island of Ireland, and the whole earth. It's amazing that each of these pictures shows us the same thing, but they look so different. And it's like that when we read scripture. We have the familiar, recognizable places, but we can understand them better when we zoom out. That's what E100 has done. It's given us the helicopter view. We've been able to see how different bits fit together, what things are different and specific, and what things carry through the whole of Scripture. And I love how that last video highlighted over and over again that love was the golden thread running through the whole story. In that Google Earth way of reading scripture, we allow ourselves to be shaped by the big story. Some feedback we received throughout the series was that people kept wanting to pause and spend longer on particular parts of the Bible. And so, that's what we're going to do next. The opposite of the Google Earth way of reading scripture is to zoom right in as far as we can, to choose a piece of scripture and stay there to examine it closely. The microscope view, where we allow ourselves to be shaped by the details and the specifics. We're going to hear more about that in a moment. But I want to finish with the image that Alan began our teaching with way back in September, a spiral staircase. And I would love to show you that, but I think we're having a few technical issues. We might be able to bring you a picture of a spiral staircase in a moment, but you just imagine it. We began the E100 series on the same day that Jewish communities began their reading pattern. They read the first five books of the Bible completely every year. The same stories, the same words, year after year after year. And we might think, what's the point? What's the point of all this reading? Why would we read the same scriptures? And the Jewish response is, yes, we are going around in circles. We are in the same place we were last time around. But now, we're another floor higher.
It was in the last part of the Acts of the Apostles. The amazing thing was that Paul never gave up. You know, he was thrown in prison, he was beaten, he was shipwrecked many times, and you know, people really were out to get him, but he kept going. He kept going. And I sense God saying, you know, even when you are an old codger, you got to keep going. the work isn't finished yet. So I want to say to all those other old codgers, male and female, there's work for us to do. So let's keep going.
I want to keep on going with reading the Bible. And in many ways, there is so much in the Bible that it is a lifetime's work reading through it, which can sound daunting, but I think of it as a meal or food for the soul, with the food spread out on the table like a buffet with all types of food and all flavours and like a buffet, I can come and go from the table. And depending on the day, whether I will have a lot of food on the plate or a smaller portion. And there is some of the food I would like better than the others, but it is good that I can make the effort to try all types of the food.
All relationships need work, and that for us to truly commit to something is when we stand to gain the most. If you want to hear, then you first have to listen. Taking time each evening to read, consider, and listen to words from the passages. That's really what I think I've heard God saying.
I can use commentaries or Bible reading notes as a help to explain the passage. It's a bit like a menu which describes what the food consists of. Encouraging to love and enjoy reading the Bible, and also to get to know more about God.
And I sense God saying to us all, you know something? You ain't seen nothing yet.
You ain't seen nothing yet. Well, if E100 was like going up in a helicopter, as Michael put it, to see the big picture, I want to tell you now about where we're going to go to next. Beginning on Sunday, the 18th of April, we're going to take another shared journey together as a whole church family to look at Jesus's longest sermon. We call it the Sermon on the Mount. We're taking the helicopter down, as it were, to land and to explore the landscape of a particular place. And this is such an important place to explore. So from Sunday the 18th of April, over 18 weeks through spring and summer, each Sunday we're going to explore the Sermon of the Mount. And we're going to be able to think about different questions such as, how do we find the secret of happiness? How do we handle anger? How should we view marriage and divorce? How do we handle money? How do we deal with difficult people? And so many other questions of our ordinary, everyday lives. So we hope that you'll look forward to that, and there'll be more details about that in weeks to come. But for now, Barry is going to lead us in our prayers.
Let us pray. We look forward to the time when we will gather together in one place. O righteous Father, we appreciate everything that you have given to us. Thank you for granting us the gift of life and our health. And we appreciate the blessing of being able to gather in your presence. And we do look forward to the time when we will gather to exalt you again, which is the reason why you created us. We worship and praise you through our lives. Our glory and our purpose in life is to worship and serve you. Holy Spirit, strengthen us to worship the holiness of God and to know the blessings of worship. Keep us close to you and in good health and spirit as we continue to serve you in Jesus' name. Amen. And we thank God for our E100 readings that we have been going through. O God, we thank you today for the E100 readings and for all the sacred scriptures. We thank you for the comfort the Bible has brought to the sorrowful, for guidance offered to the bewildered, for its gracious promises to the uncertain, for its strength given to the weak, and for its progressive revelation of yourself. We thank you for the people of God who speak to us still from its pages, and for the men and women of God whose learning has made those pages live. We thank you most of all that it reveals to us your Son, the Word made flesh. Help us to continue to ponder this record of your ways with women and men, that your word may be indeed a lamp to our feet and a light to our path, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And we pray for the distribution of Bibles throughout the world. Father, help us who love and treasure the Holy Scriptures to be faithful in sending your written word to places where we cannot go, and in making it available to people whose language we cannot speak. We thank you that this is possible through the work of the Bible societies throughout the world. Prosper and multiply all that they do, that increasing multitudes may read the scriptures in their mother tongue and learn of your saving love revealed to us in your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. In these troublesome days of the pandemic, we pray that the nations of the world will act together, sharing their resources. Heavenly Father, may your Holy Spirit lead the rich nations to support the poor, and the strong nations to protect the weak, so that every nation may develop and recover in its own way, and work together with other nations in true partnership for the promotion of peace and the good of all humankind, through Jesus Christ our Lord. We remember those whom we love who can't be with us in these days, who can't travel, who perhaps live away. We pray for the absent members of our families. Heavenly Father, you are present everywhere and care for all your children. We commend to you the members of our families who are now parted from us. Watch over them and protect them from all harm. Surround them and us with your love, and bring us all at last to that home where partings are no more, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And today is Census Day, and we're reminded of a time when a census was taken in the Middle East. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. So Joseph went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. We give thanks to you, Father, for the gift of your Son to be our Saviour, for the love of Christ in taking our human nature, and for his lowly birth at Bethlehem. And we thank you too for the great redemption he has brought to us and to all humankind through Calvary and his glorious resurrection. And with the angelic host, we too would cry in our day, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill towards all. Amen.
Let's pray. Lord, thank you for your great love and your goodness, that your mercy never fails, that you have led us through the fire and in the darkest nights. You are a father and a friend who is close to us. So Lord, as we leave this time of worship and we go back into our ordinary everyday lives, may we know you with us. May you bless us and keep us. May you make your face to shine upon us and be gracious to us. May, Lord, you turn your face towards us and give us peace. Amen.